Hello, welcome back to Prospect Kentucky. May 2nd, 2020, the first weekend in May, and we all know what that means. A big day in Louisville, Kentucky. It's the Kentucky Derby Day. Literally the biggest day of the year for Kentucky and Louisville specifically. As you all know, due to the coronavirus pandemic, we're skipping the Derby today. 80 degrees, no rain clouds in the sky, no derby. Unheard of. But in any case, we go on. The derby's been postponed, maybe in September. Today, I've been seeing video after video on the internet, live streams on Instagram, TikToks, everyone's making the mint julep. But I promised y'all I'm going to show you my mint julep, and so that's what we're going to do today. So welcome back to another edition of Bourbon and Books with a Doctor. I'm Dr. Andrew DiGruccio, orthopedic surgeon and amateur mixologist, and today is our Kentucky Derby special. So let's start off by looking at the official Derby glasses that I've gotten over the last few years from the last several Kentucky Derbies. We'll be making our mint julep in the glass that would have been this year's official glass. They made thousands of these, and they sold them for 50 cents a piece at the Kroger. So we picked some up, of course. So in any case, I'm going to take some time to talk about the mint julep itself there to clarify several things. We already established that the Old Fashioned is the official cocktail of Louisville, Kentucky. It is not the mint julep. The mint julep is the official cocktail of the Kentucky Derby, and that is all. Now, several other things. The official bourbon of the Kentucky Derby is Woodford Reserve. But the actual bourbon used in all of the mint juleps at Churchill Downs on the day of the Derby is Old Forester. That's okay. They're not really rivals. They're both made by Brown-Forman, and I'm sure Brown-Forman doesn't really care which one you use in your mint julep. So in any case, the other thing about the mint julep is it's not the most sophisticated or tricky bourbon cocktail. It's very easy to make. And of course it is, because these are mass-produced on one day by vendors to pass out to thousands and thousands of people. So they had to come up with something that represented the bourbon culture, featured a glass that you could keep, and kept you cool on potentially a hot day, so they kind of made it like a slushie. So let's get right into it. Very easy concept. We're going to start with our graduated cylinder, and today I'm featuring the Wild Turkey Kentucky Spirit, because why not? And it calls for a pretty stiff pour of bourbon, about 2.5 ounces. Now, what most people are going to tell you when they have their first mint julep is it tastes like kind of watered down bourbon. It's not really that fancy, because the only other ingredient is mint infused simple syrup, 1 ounce. I pre-measured that out, but I want to tell you how I made this. This is our simple syrup recipe, 1 cup of sugar, 1 cup of water, high heat on the stovetop until the sugar dissolves, and then you pour it into a glass with some fresh cut mint, and you let it sit there, and the mint oils steep into that simple syrup. If you leave it overnight, it often turns almost green in color, but it has this beautiful aroma of mint, and that helps flavor this cocktail. So we're just gonna give that a stir, and that's basically all this cocktail calls for. But what's key to making it palatable is that you have to serve it almost like a slushie. So let's start putting some of the ice that's crushed up. We've made our ice in the blender almost like a slushie, and I'll pour that right into that, but we're not done there. You keep building up the ice in the glass. Until it's literally heaping over. That will do. You make a little the hole for a straw and you get some fresh mint. Now, I've taken some. I use a variety of mint called chocolate mint. It seems to grow very nicely around here. And what you're going to do with your mint is you're going to wake it up with a little smack in between your hands. That immediately gets it to release all of its magic. And you're going to put that, and you can take a couple of these and put it right around where your straw goes in. Why do you want it right where your straw goes in? Because when you go to drink this strong bourbon cocktail, you want that mint to hit you right in the nose at the same time you take your sip. Actually very good, but a strong bourbon cocktail. Many people will get this at the Derby, and it's hot outside. The ice is already mostly melted. It tastes like a watered-down bourbon with a little sugar in it. The mint comes wilted, but if you get it fresh at the bar, it can be quite good, and this is how it should look. So that's the mint julep, how I do it, in the official Kentucky Derby glass, and with my own official mint-infused syrup. Now, let's pair that with a book. I don't have a Kentucky Derby book to recommend to you today, but I will recommend a very interesting medical book called Blood Work. I find this book fascinating because it talks about the history of blood transfusion as a therapy, as a modality in medicine. And a lot of people just assume we've been doing this forever. But in the 1600s in France, where they were defining a lot of the current medical practices, transfusion had not even started. And a daring surgeon started trying research and using blood transfusion for therapy. And he actually transfused a man. It was thought that it might help solve his insane lunatic problems. And the academic institutions in Paris at the time condemned the research in transfusion and thought that it was blasphemous. So they went so far as to murder the patient of this surgeon and blame the surgeon for the death of this person he transfused. The surgeon then went on trial for murder, where the judge determined he was innocent of the charges. But the judge in his decision also declared that blood transfusion therapy was too controversial, not well enough understood, and bucked the standards too far. Therefore, he condemned transfusion and felt it had no place in medicine at the time. What this court decision exonerating the surgeon of murder did is hold back transfusion therapy for up to 200 years and stopped all research into the concept. So it's a really fascinating historical piece of medical history, and I strongly recommend it. Maybe not today on the Derby day. Maybe you've got other things to do. If the Derby was running, we'd be betting and drinking more mint juleps. But on another day, give this book a try. In any case, we're still in the middle of our coronavirus isolation. We're healthy at work now, but we're still social distancing. We're wearing masks. We're washing hands. We're washing surfaces. And we're only going back to work in a very safe capacity. As we slowly come out of this, remember there's going to be a second surge of infections, and we still have to protect ourselves, but we mostly have to protect each other. So please be careful out there. Enjoy a mint julep, and don't be surprised if you find this to be a very strong cocktail. You really got to go for your ice work and your mint infusion syrup and fresh mint. That's the only way to make this into a good cocktail. Nastrovia.